shame. He disarmed the rulers and the authorities, which means the principalities. So now let's go back to put to shame. So now the shame is no longer on us. The shame is on him, because the Bible says he put them to shame openly. So that means Jesus outshined the devil. He outclassed the devil. He overshadowed the devil. He eclipsed the devil. He surpassed the devil. He excelled the devil. He was superior to the devil. He outstripped the devil. He outdone the devil. He put the devil in shade. He upstaged the devil. He left him behind. He showed him up. He humbled him. He ran rings around him. And he is the head and shoulders above the devil. And since he lives in me, I outshine the devil. I outclass the devil. I overshadow the devil. I eclipse the devil. I surpass the devil. Well, shouldn't you have shame? Yes, I should have shame. But for my shame, he gave me double. So I excel the devil. I'm superior to the devil. I outstrip the devil. I outdo the devil. I put the devil in shade. I upstage the devil. I leave him behind. I humble him. I run rings around him. And I'm the head and I'm not the tail. Not shame on me, shame on you, devil. Let's read verse 15 again. I'll read that. He disarmed the rulers and authorities and put them to open shame by triumphing over them in him. Now some of the stuff you couldn't see, it looked like he was just dying on the cross. But in him, he was controlling everything and overthrowing everything. And because we are in him, then we get everything that he got as long as we stay in him. You can throw this in the ocean, and guess what's going to happen to the bottle? The bottle's now going to be in the ocean. So here's the thing. Jesus came in us, but we don't get the full benefits until we get in him. So as long as he comes in me, yes, some things will change. But if I want to be surrounded by him, if I want to drown in him, if I want to sink in him, I got to get in him the way he got in me. Yes, it was amazing that he got in me, but don't let that be enough. You need to get in him. And if any man be in Christ, he is a new creature. The reason why I did some stupid stuff is because I stepped out of him. But when I stay in him, guess what? You're going to recognize my life is going to be different because I'm going to be drowning in him. And here's the thing. The only way you could get the bottle out of the ocean, you got to get in the ocean to get the bottle. So if you're going to try to get me and distract me, you got to get in Christ to find me because I'm in Christ. And it's time for us to be in him. All the promises of God, they are yes and amen in him. In him do we live. In him do we move. In him do we have our being. Now here's my question. Is there any shame in him? If there's no shame in him, then there's no shame in me. Is there any defeat in him? If there's no defeat in him, there's no defeat in me. Yes, I may go through something that looks like I'm losing, but I can never lose as long as I'm in him.